Hello, my friends. Today I'm going to discuss this very delicate subject, and that is that studio monitors, many persons think they have good speakers while using studio monitors in their living room. And before I start, I want to say that I'm not a hater. I do not hate any speaker brand or amplifier brand. There's only one brand I absolutely dislike, and that's Bose. And people who knows me, the reason is because they sell crap for a very expensive price. They make some good professional stuff. So for the PA stuff, they had a good line in the past. Not sure if they still making professional PA equipment, but for the living room, their living room speakers, it is, you know, crap for the price you pay. Yeah, for the price they are selling their speakers. Okay, that's the only brand I think I dislike. You know, I have some Bose stuff over here. I have to review it, because as soon as I review Bose stuff, my count goes up, you know, because Bose is popular. They are very good in the commercial stuff. Every young person, when I speak, first brand is, well, in the first three brands, there's always Bose, okay? I do not hate brands. Let's be, because I'm going to lose, with this video, I'm going to lose subscribers, because this is a very delicate subject, and people are stubborn and think that I do not know nothing about this subject. But okay, this ad I saw today, not sure when he plays it online, the JBL 4312 MK2, yeah, the guy is selling it for 1800 euro, and then I start googling, or he have more ads over here, and he also have this ad, the JBL 4333A mint, 8000 euro. And then I saw this picture, and I saw that there was something wrong with this picture. Probably you won't see that immediately, but there is something wrong with this picture. Because what's wrong with this picture is where this speaker is. The speaker is standing in the living room, because here you see a living room set up. And these speakers are studio monitors, yeah? So they are not made for a living room. I'm going to explain you later why. So if somebody, they are beautiful speakers, beautiful speakers, my friends, I admit that, yes, and they are from very good quality, but not for the living room, yeah. And these are studio monitors, yeah. You have home, well, most speakers are for what you buy in the shops, they are for your living room. These are just good speakers, and that you can use in your living room. But these speakers are absolutely, it is no use to buy these speakers, because they speakers from 500 euro, no, living room speakers from 300 euro sounds better, yeah, can sounds better than these 8000 euro costing speakers. And if you want to spend 8000 euro for speakers, oh my friends, I do not have this money. But if you want to spend 8000 euro for speakers, buy speakers what are not studio monitors, because those speakers are made for the living room, and the sound between those speakers and these speakers is a huge difference. Yeah, so I think what is this guy selling, you know, this guy, you know, people who buy these speakers, yes, they I'm not sure why they buy. Probably they didn't do their homework. But it took me a while to discover the difference between studio monitors and normal speakers. And I think I was already in this hobby for, I think, 4 or 5 years before I finally understand why the GBL L100, why I didn't like them, and more, because it is, that's why this video is very important. Just watch it out, the complete video. And because some of you who have these speakers, who have studio monitors in their living room, will say, well, they are perfect speakers, they sound perfect. Well, if you really think they are sounding perfect, you don't know what is perfect, and I'm going to explain you later. My first studio monitor, the GBL L100. This is the video from the GBL L100. This is 6 years ago. This was my first experience I had, and I tested it with a Harman Kardon 730 Twin. Now, a Harman Kardon, let me show you what is a Harman Kardon 730 Twin. Yeah, this is the Harman Kardon. Yeah, this thing, if you like the sound of Marantz, this Harman Kardon goes even deeper than a Marantz. I think too deep, for my speakers, because I have I only have speakers always what I like personally in my living room, my taste. They are speakers, floor standers, with a very, they start very low. So when this thing is playing, it is going too low for my taste. Yeah. But if you have speakers, what start at 45 Hertz, 40 Hertz, 45 Hertz, this amplifier can be a perfect match, yeah. But my speakers often start below 30 Hertz, even below 25 Hertz. So my speakers goes low, very low. So for those speakers, this Harman Kardon 730 is not suitable. But it is a very fine and good amplifier or receiver. So this receiver is very colored. It is not a neutral sounding receiver, very, very colored. And I tested those GBL L100s with this very colored receiver. And I heard I heard something, and I very strange. It is the first time and the last time that I gave a opinion, and my opinion was so. You have what's heard this opinion, what I gave.
Two were not good enough anymore. So now I am hunting for speakers above these GBLs. And why that is, well, I'm not sure. I think I missed some highs. The highs are, the mid is very good. The mid tweeters and Yamaha and...
Anyway, my opinion was I left it in the middle. I advise you, before you buy them, go to listen them first, not buy them blindfold. Okay, is everything working? Sound test, tweeter is working, mid is working, bass is working, I buy them. No, sound test, that was my advice, go first listen them, because at that period, 2015, I knew that when I told the truth, I would lose many subscribers, and at that time I was afraid to lose subscribers. So it was the first and last time I didn't lie, but I did not dare to tell the truth, about this speaker. But the truth was that the speaker had no dynamic at all. No, speaker was sounding harsh. The tweeter was not sounding nice. It was more mids, as it was terrible sounding speaker. So when I tried to sell this speaker, the guy came. I placed the speakers upstairs in my hallway with an amplifier, and these were beautiful speakers, but so from the outside they were beautiful. So this guy came to my house, and these speakers are expensive, and I think I sold them too cheap. But that's because I didn't think that people would buy them because of this sound. But this guy came to my house, and I connected the speakers and played some songs for him, and he said to me, "Yes, this is it." And I thought, what is this guy hearing what I miss? I mean, something wrong with my ears. But guys, you know, it is like a placebo. I don't know if you know what is a placebo. If you go to placebo, the test, and you have the placebo, suddenly you feel better. A big part of those persons who had those placebos, they suddenly feel better with that pill, yeah? And that pill was really nothing, you know, really nothing in that pill. But they, and some people think because GBL is a cult speaker, yeah, these L100s are cult speakers, and people think, well, I bought the real thing now, you know, they read a lot. I mean, just Google on GBL L100s and you see plenty forums with a lot of GBL L100 talks. That is a good speaker, perfect sounding, but these speakers are not made. They are maybe perfect, but for the studio, not for home use, my friends. Yeah, that's a big difference, and I'm going to explain you later why. Yeah, so keep watching this video. Okay, this was my first after 4 years, this was my first studio monitor, and I did not know at that time that it was a studio monitor, that it didn't make me happy in sound. Okay, then I scored this video. Is very nice. I was scoring the GBL 4312A, also a studio monitor, and it was a nice video, very nice video.
32 years.
And this was a nice piece. I was with my sister, and my sister made this remark. Listen to this.
Andrew, they are very old speakers. I don't like them.
You don't like them?
No.
A woman, my friends. She don't like the old speakers. They don't know what they're talking about. They don't have any feelings for nostalgic, for sound, you know. Woman is good for kitchen cleaning and, of course, a lot of other things, but not for speaker. Do not ever ask them, what do you think from the speakers? What do you think from the amplifier? What do you think from the sound? Never ask them. Because the answer you will get is not the answer you need, you know.
I'm crazy. When I see this video back, I'm really a crazy person. Eh? But okay, I brought these speakers home. Yeah, I think, okay, maybe these sounds good. You know, the GBL 100s was not my taste. But I came to the same conclusion, and I still didn't understand why people want to pay so much money. I mean, I didn't pay much money for these speakers. I paid €250 for them. I drove, I think, 200 kilometers, not sure, or 150. I'm not sure. Just watch the scoring video. It's a very nice video. But, you know, but persons who are going to pay €1,800 for these speakers, I'm sorry, it's throwing away money. Okay, you can always resell them, because there are many GBL lovers who think these are good speakers. You do not want, I mean, for €1,800, my friends, even my Heiko the statements didn't cost me €1,800. They are perfect sounding speakers, my friends. Yes, and these speakers, they are awful sounding speakers for the living room, but for the producer in the studio, yeah, good speakers, yeah, and I'm going to explain you that. And what about this? So this guy is using them not in a studio but in his living room, because you can see this living room setup. The amplifier is a perfect amplifier. I'm gonna make videos, the perfect second handset for under 1,000 euro, you know, and under 1,500 euro or for 2,000 euro, because I think I have to, in the amplifier section it is easy. It is easy. Speakers are always the difficult thing, the most difficult thing to decide. They are the end of the line, the complete line, and there's so much difference in speaker sound that's why I am always playing with speakers over here. But these speakers, even if they look fantastic, they are good speakers, very good speakers for the studio, not for the living room. Okay. So, but I had these speakers, I bought these speakers, I did the test, yes, I did the test over here, and these were, so this was the Canton Ergo RCLs, and these were the MB Quartz 800, beautiful sounding speakers, beautiful. I now have the 1000, still didn't test it, but I have the 1000, so I'm curious about that sound. It will be in one of those, this VS test. I'm just saving more speakers to have more speakers in the test. Anyway, so I still didn't understand why these speakers sounded so bad. Was it something with my taste? Or, you know, I think, why do people pay so much money? You know, for, I didn't know it was a studio speaker at that time. Didn't know that. I just thought, okay, I buy these speakers. In some countries, they are selling for 1,000, 1,500 euro a pair, so they have to be good. Normally, if you do not know what to buy, you do not read magazines, you do not follow videos as I make, or other creators on YouTube who make videos and tests, and they give their opinion and their advice, You don't have time for that, you know. The easiest way how to know if you buy good speakers or not is to follow the price, to follow the second-hand price, not the new price. That's something completely different. The second-hand price, if these speakers are five years or older than 5 years, because in the second-hand price, yes, after a few years, people bought these speakers, they know exactly what these speakers are, and the price is the exact value of these speakers, the second-hand price. So not if you have only two prices, but if a speaker is popular and they are and you see them often on the second-hand market, you go to Hi-Fi Shark, you see, okay, the maximum is 700, minimum is 500. You know that this speaker is worth, sound-wise, 600 euro. And that counts for most speakers. Most. Only the very old speakers, some of them, so speakers from 25 years, sometimes 20 years and above, you can find them much more cheaper while they have a higher value. But because they are old and looking old-fashioned, or another reason, people do not want to buy these speakers. But speakers from between 5 and, let's say, 20 years old, you can exactly see on the price, you know, what is the quality of this speaker. You know, if you do not know nothing about speakers and you do not know what to buy, yeah, and you have money in your pocket, you say, okay, I want to spend 500 euro for speakers, then just, you know, if you see some speakers you like from the outside, you're going to see on Hi-Fi Shark what's the price people pay for these speakers, you know. That doesn't count for studio monitors. Never buy studio monitors for your living room. If you buy speakers, you see speakers, you're going to Google them and add the word studio. If you see that this speaker is a studio monitor, do not buy it for your house. Okay. My next experience was this Tandberg studio monitor. And it is an impressive speaker, if you see it, yeah. And really, my friends, then I understand what was going on, because of this comment. Many of you also do not know, maybe you never had studio monitors, but because I missed something in the sound, and some of you were saying, okay, you have to place stand below them. These speakers need stands. That's why they sound so bad. But then I had this comment, and read with me, please. They are not hi-fi speakers. They are full-range studio monitors. They are not meant to make for a pleasurable listening experience. They are designed to accurately reflect what is being put into them. Unlike hi-fi speakers, which are designed to flatter the music, in other words, unlike hi-fi speakers, they are precision measuring instruments. Also, they are designed to be soffit mounted in the wall, not to be used floor standing. I'm a mastering engineer. Listen to this, my friends. I'm a mastering engineer, and I use these as my reference monitors in my studio. I would never listen to commercial released music on them, as well as all they will do is highlight every tonal error, harshness, and tonal imbalance in the music. This is what they are designed to do. Comparing them with hi-fi speakers is like comparing a family hatchback with an off-road 4x4. They are not the same thing, and you'll go very wrong if you try and confuse the two. As regards the price, in order to get a set of reference studio monitors of a similar specification, you would be looking at a price from 8,000 to 10,000 English pounds. So that's a lot of money. Okay, then I understand. This was a studio engineer. Yeah, this guy knew what a mastering engineer. This guy knew what he was talking. So he wrote here that he would never. These are the best speakers for the studio, but he would never use them in a living room. Yeah. Still, I did not really understand it. I understand this, you know, because that's why I like to see comments, and some comments are very usable. This was a very I learned a lot of this few lines, you know. And then I had this. I scored this Yamaha NS10M. Yeah. As you see the speakers, they are small speakers, terrible sounding speakers, and they have a value from €600. And this is a very nice video, because the guy who was selling this speakers, he was a musician, and he was already old, so he started selling his stuff, and really it was a fantastic day I had in that house. This guy was playing music, and I recorded it, and so a nice guy, and also his woman was also a musician. Beautiful afternoon I had in Belgium, Brasschaat. And then I brought the speakers home, and I made a video, because they had some glue over here, and how I cleaned the glue away from those speakers, and I managed to get all that glue away. And then I made that review. And this is what what was my opinion.
And I tested them last week, and I must say I was so disappointed in the sound. But yeah, now I know for 100% sure. These are my first. I'm not sure if the GBLs were also. They were not really studio monitors, but these are my first studio monitors. I was just curious about the sound, And well, it's the last time I bought a studio monitor, you know, and because, you know, people say, yeah, this cable is better, and you try it out, this thing is better, you try it out. And of course, the name studio says it all.
Anyway, I have, so this is when I finally discovered the truth, because a guy who bought these speakers from me was a producer. And I asked him, so why you pay 600 euro for these speakers? He said they are the best. They're one of the best studio monitors. So these Yamaha NS10M are the best studio monitors. And I told him, so what, explain me why you do not use these speakers, for example. So I showed him some speakers. He said, well, when I am producing music and they sound perfect on these studio monitors, then they sound beautiful on hi-fi living room speakers. But they are not made for the living room, you know, they are not, because you will never have a beautiful sound of them. Yeah, you, for a master engineer or a producer, he exactly, these speakers are exactly for that purpose, to hear every fault. If you not have the trumpet too loud, the drum too loud, and get the music as best as you can over these speakers. And if the result, the end result, is finished, then this guy, he told me, then it goes on CD, and then it is the product is finished for the living room, for the living room speaker. That's a studio monitor, my friends. And that's why people pay for these speakers 600 euro, because producers make a lot of money. And it is for them important. These speakers sound very flat. There's no dynamic at all in those speakers. And that same counts for those GBL speakers, those L100s, and these speakers. So I'm not a GBL hater, my friends. Not at all. Not at all. But they are not made for your living room. Please try to understand that as a GBL owner, if you own the speakers, I can give you this advice. If you are an owner, you are not a producer. You are just a listener like me and many others. Sell these speakers. Buy for this money. You can buy hell of a speakers, my friends. Even my speakers are not 1800 euro. And what about this? 8000. But these speakers will not make you happy. If you are happy with these speakers, you have these speakers in your house, you sell these speakers, you get your 8000, you buy for that 8000 hi-fi speakers, yeah, well, I think you will jump a hole in the air. So happy you will be in the sound difference you will hear. Because speakers from 8000 euro sounds fantastic. And you cannot compare speakers from 8000 euro with my speakers. But my speakers sounds better in my living room than these 8000 costing GBL 4333. I can give you that on a paper. I never heard them, but I can tell you now 100% that my speakers sounds better than these speakers for the living room, not for the studio. For the studio, my speakers are worthless. For the studio, you need speakers like this, you know, or those Yamahas, or those Tandbergs, yes. So, people, please understand, if you have these speakers, I'm not a hater from GBL. Sell these speakers, buy some, you know, these speakers are not meant to be for the living room, you know. You will not hear GBL. GBL is very happy. GBL is very happy that people buy these speakers for the living room. Why not? Why shouldn't they be happy, you know? It's a cult speaker. GBL, these all the GBLs, they are all cult speakers. But my friends, they are not meant to be for the living room. There are studio monitors, and I cannot understand that you like that sound. You know, I just showed you what this guy, this master engineer who had those Tandbergs, he told them they are the best studio monitors, but they are absolutely not suitable for the living room, because also those Tandbergs didn't make me happy. They didn't have dynamic at all. They were straight flat line speakers, not nice to hear, my friends. And I had many speakers, so I know what it took me a while before I discovered why these speakers didn't sound good in my ears, you know, because I didn't understand first why. I mean, why do these people pay so much money for these speakers? Well, they are bad sounding speakers. They're not bad sounding speakers. They're very good sounding speakers for the studio. But for the living room, they are bad sounding speakers. So please, 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 if you have these speakers, if you have studio monitors in your living room, try to sell them and buy some decent hi-fi for the same money. Believe me, you will be very thankful if you watch this video and you follow my advice and you have studio monitors, you thought, okay, these are perfect sounding living room speakers, you have studio monitors, you will thank me on your knees, because you finally discovered that your studio monitor speakers in your living room are not suitable for your living room. Because that's why I make this video, because there's still many persons out there who do not agree with me, and they are betting with me that they are perfect sounding speakers, those JBL L100s for example. I lost many subscribers when I told these people the truth about this speaker, because these people, okay, this is an idiot reviewer. What does this reviewer know? This reviewer is stupid, because he says the JBL 4312 sounds terrible, you know. But you know, I hope in this video, you know, I finally can come into your brains, you know, and maybe you should, you know, see your speaker as, okay, maybe this guy is right, you know, let's try out another speaker, a hi-fi speaker, you know, and you will see that I am right, that your speaker, your all those years, not sure how long you already are listening to those JBLs or those Tandbergs, or, well, I'm not sure if people have these little Yamahas in their home, they are not impressive looking. No, these speakers are not cult speakers. Yeah, they are cult speakers on the studio producers, but not on the normal people. So in many studios, when you see pictures from studio, you will see these little Yamahas. They are little, but they have a value from €600. And they sound awful. They are awful sounding speakers, my friends. But for the studio, they are perfect. And not sure. I'm not a studio speaker tester. I cannot tell you which studio speaker is better, or studio monitor is better. The JBL L100, the 4312, the Tandberg, or this one. I cannot tell you, because I do not judge speakers in this way. I am, you know, this is a different kind of listening. A studio monitor is a different kind of listening, you know. So I cannot tell you, yes, the from all those speakers, the Tandberg sounded best, you know. But for the living room, you know, for the studio use, I'm not sure which one is finally the best speaker to use if you are a producer. You know, I do not make videos for producers. I'm not a producer, so I do not care. So, but I have this experience. I didn't know the first 4 years or 5 years why these speakers sounded so bad. But in the years, I start learning more and more. Also because of that comment I just showed you of the Tandberg speaker. Then you start learning. That's why I like comments. I learn from comments. I'm still learning, my friends. Everybody is still learning. Everybody who is in this music hobby, in this audio hobby, is still learning. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Please don't forget to place those thumbs up. Very important, my friends. Place those thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you didn't do that yet. And for now, I say ciao, ciao.